Right, I have the memory allocator working, which means I can now run an interactive shell. So let me go ahead and reboot here. It initializes everything, and then I can type in some text. And over, you know, this is just typing out. So foo-par-baz. Let's see, there was an option here. So foo-to, something like that. And if I press enter, it's able to detect my input string, split it into its four tokens, foo, bar, baz, and the option. And you can see the memory addresses are, you know, 60AO, 60CO. So these are dynamically allocated addresses. So if I actually type in some additional options, so A, B, C, D, E, F, G, so just a bunch of extra stuff, you'll see that it can actually allocate new memory. So it freed the memory that was there before. So you see that those initial addresses, CO, AO, CO, EO, are reused. But then there's some new addresses that are coming up to allocate for these extra strings. So all this is happening dynamically using malloc and free. And it means I can now start processing user input in a shell.